Hi, my name is William Bryan, and I am the writer, director, and producer of Nobody, a short film about Elvis in his senior year of high school at Humes in 1953, and how he was reluctantly entered into the senior year talent show.
Okay, can you tell us about your film?
Would you like me to look at the camera or look at you? What looks more aesthetically pleasing?
The camera.
Okay. What was that first question again?
Can you tell us about your film?
Absolutely. Well, where to start? I guess the beginning is always a good point. I've been an Elvis fan since I was 12, and I've been a filmmaker since I was 9. And I knew growing up, loving two of those things, that I always wanted to tell an Elvis story. Having just graduated from Columbia College Chicago, my mentor, who was a film professor there, at one point recommended to me that I do a short film, because that's sort of what I had been trained in. And you grow up your whole life thinking, the ambiguous 10 years from now, I'm going to be making a feature film about Elvis. And he said, do a short film. You're experienced in that. You'll be able to, more likely get it off the ground in that format. And you can tell a much more human story. It won't have to be so condensed in 2 hours. And so that's where we went from there. And idea for the film hit me last summer, 2012, when I was reading a book that I had had since I was 13 years old, Early Elvis, the Humes Years by Bill Burke. And there is a section in there where it talks about how Elvis was entered into the senior year talent show, and the show was set up to whoever did the best performance would get an encore. Whoever got the biggest applause would get to do an encore performance. And fate had it that, who do you think won? Elvis. And he got to go out and do a second song, and this show went over really well that night. And what's really fascinating me about this is that we get to tell a very positive human story of who Elvis was, but arguably this is the point that jump-started his career. I mean, you could easily, backtrack that to when he got his first guitar. But this is the first time as a young adult man that he really wowed an audience as big as the huge auditorium that's at Humes High School. And, this was at a time before he even cut his first record. That would have been a couple months later that summer when he walked into Sun Studios and cut My Happiness for a gift for his mother, as they so say. But I've often liked to wonder, how would things have played out had he gotten booed off stage that night? Would he have ever had the confidence to go into Sun for the first time? And so what we do with our film is we cut it off. We end it right when he walks into Sun for the first time. And we just try to show a very positive human portrait of who he was as an 18-year-old.
All right. What are your dreams for the film, your expectations?
So as to say, if I could have the film go
yes.
my ultimate way. Well, if I could have the film work out to my largest expectations, we're here during Elvis Week to cast it. We're going to be shooting it in the fall, and what I'm hoping is that it can get off the ground and that we can enter it into major film festivals worldwide. There's certainly an Elvis following overseas and, of course, in the United States, and I think this story has a lot of potential, but my ultimate goal with any of this is to continue Elvis's amazing legacy and to hopefully give people that might not be fans yet a sense of appreciation for who he was, and maybe give them a better understanding of why guys like me appreciate him.
Okay, I think that is enough for right now.
Okay, wonderful.